Good evening. My name is Kacper Paradowski, and you are watching Poland Daily News. Today, on the last day of his official visit to Italy and the Vatican, Polish President Andrzej Duda, his wife and the Polish delegation met with Pope Francis. After the meeting, Duda published a tweet about the conversation with the Pope about how each person, within the limits of their abilities, can try to act in such a way as to always and everywhere strive for peace. Andrzej Duda is the first head of state to be received by the Pope since the introduction of sanitary restrictions in the Vatican in March due to the coronavirus pandemic. Today, on behalf of the entire Polish nation, I participated in a holy mass held here in the Vatican. Later, together with my wife and the Polish delegation, we laid a wreath on the grave of Pope John Paul II and prayed for our homeland and nation. Andrzej Duda is the first president received by Pope Francis since the introduction of sanitary restrictions and the so-called lockdown in March this year due to the coronavirus pandemic. The president gave the Pope a copy of the picture of Our Lady of Grace, patron of Warsaw, as a gift. Duda first met with Pope Francis alone in the library at the Apostolic Palace and then with the entire Polish delegation. The president also met with the Secretary of State of His Holiness the Pope, Cardinal Pietro Parolin. After the meeting, Duda, his wife and the Polish delegation participated in a mass held by the grave of Pope John Paul II at the Papal Basilica of St. Peter. After 4 days of negotiations between the government and the trade unionists, a preliminary agreement on the conditions under which hard coal mining in Silesia will be terminated was negotiated. It was agreed that the last of the mines operating in Silesia are to be closed by the end of 2049. The agreement provides that none of the miners will lose their jobs. Today's agreement made it possible to end the strike, which was conducted in some mines. At the end of December 2019, over 83,000 people worked in the Polish coal mining industry.
I have repeatedly stressed that Silesia is a special region for me. I am all the more pleased with today's agreement with the representatives of the mining industry, which can be boldly called a breakthrough. It was possible thanks to the fact that on both sides of the negotiating table sat people who care about the development and modern energy transformation of Poland, as well as securing decent working conditions for the entire Silesian community. We made a very difficult decision, like I said at the beginning, to liquidate this most important industrial sector in Silesia. Now we have a lot of very hard work ahead of us to ensure that the system of transformation of the whole region is focused on the premise that those jobs that we will be losing in the long term are replaced by other jobs. We will want the money that goes for the reconstruction of the European Union's economy, that goes for the energy transformation to be spent by the European Union on our region and our industry. However, we don't want this money to go to the construction of bicycle paths, subsequent water parks or to new sidewalks, but to invest this money so that Silesia does not become a region from which young people will be leaving. This is the most important thing for us.
The unruly, unbreakable, cursed International Film Festival, dedicated to history, is being held in Gdynia. The festival is not only about screenings of documentary and feature films about Polish history, but also about accompanying events. More from Magdalena Bałkowiec in Gdynia.
The second day of the Unruly Unbreakable Cursed International Film Festival is also a pitching forum, which are workshops for filmmakers. Here they can present their trailers, see how they should be remodeled, see how the presentation of such a project should look like. They also have a chance to get funding and meet with television companies or other distributors who will help to promote the film and make it. The filmmakers come to the film festival only with a project for the film. Today is the final day of the pitching forum, which began on Tuesday. Further festival emotions are still ahead of us. The festival is scheduled to conclude on Sunday, during which the winners will be selected in 5 categories, including 2 new ones, feature film and music video. All this is still ahead of us on Sunday.
Mieni zwycięzcy w 5 kategoriach, w tym w 2 nowych, czyli film fabularny i wideoklip.
4 people were injured, including 2 severely injured, in a knife attack in Paris. The attack took place near the former office of the satirical weekly magazine Charlie Hebdo, where 12 people were killed in January 2015 in an attack carried out by an Islamic extremist. The investigation into today's attack was launched by the French anti-terrorist prosecutor's office.
The man suspected of committing the crime fled to the subway station. According to local media, he was accompanied by another man who was also supposed to take part in the attack. Around 12:45 p.m. local time, on the stairs of the Bastille Opera House, officers arrested a man with traces of blood on his clothes who is suspected of having committed the attack. A criminal and research intervention brigade was sent to the scene. The police secured the area as well as the neighborhood of the current editorial office of the Charlie Hebdo Weekly, to which a suspicious package was delivered this morning. A special anti-crisis unit was established at the Ministry of the Interior in connection with the attack.
That's all for tonight. Thank you for watching. Stay with us for Poland Daily Business. Good night.